Hi. In our standard component for document selection of PDF Butler, the docconfig is shown shows the name of the docconfig. In multi-language cases, you might want to show this in the language of the user. So, how we go about that? We have to create a translation data source, and I've just created one here. As you can see, it's a static values data source. So create one of those types, and with the static values data source in the bottom you will have this lightning component where you can just start adding rows. So in this case we have a docconfig that's named quote, and we want to translate this quote docconfig, this name of this docconfig, in the language of the current user. So we just add a row here. The first value, the name, has to be the name of the docconfig. So in this case, it's quote, so that's easy. Then this has to be the translation. In my language, which is Dutch, you would say offerte. So, and my current locale, that's the combination of my country and my language. It would be NL for my language and BE for Belgium. So that's where I reside. Cool, let's add another row. This is now saved. Let's add another row. Again, it's on quote. And I'm going to call this Devi, which is the French translation. So let's go for French, not in Belgium, but actually let's go for French in France. So that's French France, the locale for this one. Okay. Maybe you want a default one, maybe if none of the languages match and you don't want to call it a quote, then you can just add an extra row. You can say, I want to call it, oh, it's for the quote, to translate the quote one. And I'm going to call this my quote, for instance, and I'm not going to enter a locale to it. So let's save this. Now, let's refresh the page and let's see if my three items are there. Yeah, so I have the one for the Dutch in Belgium, I have the one for France in France, and I have a default one. Cool. Let's copy the ID of this data source, go to our our opportunity here. So just an object where our component sits, do the edit page, and now I'm just going to configure this component to use this translation data source. So I'm going to indicate this one, so I'm going to select this one. In the bottom there is the translation data source to select, so I'm going to do now save. It immediately switched it to offerte, which means my user is currently in Dutch Belgium. So I did this. Let's do a save and then go back. In the meantime, let's take a look at my user, which is indeed Dutch Belgium. And Dutch Belgium is the locale NL underscore BE. So this, it takes this locale and shows the translation for that quote. So now it says offerte. Let's switch my user over to French in France. And then normally it would show, let's go for French, not Belgium, but French in France. Where was it? Here. So French in France, if I save this. So now my user is French in France. I would expect to see Devi instead of quote or offerte. And indeed, now it's translated into Devi, so this translation worked. If I change my setting to, for instance, let's say English in UK or something, English United Kingdom, so there is no translation for English in United Kingdom. What I want to do then is, of course, just see the default one, which would say my quote. Okay, cool. So what happens now if you do not specify a default one? That's perfectly possible. If you remove this row over here, let's refresh it to double check if the row is removed. So I don't have a default one. The default would actually now be the name of my .conf in Salesforce. So if I refresh that one, it would just say quote and not my quote anymore. So yeah, let's add another one. I am not very strong, powerful in translations. So let's add one for Portuguese. Yeah, I can't even pronounce it, but I'm just gonna copy it, and I'm gonna say here that add a row, and it's gonna be for quote. And if I take the put the item here, and then it's gonna be Portuguese in Portugal, so PTPT. Let's save this. Okay, now I switch my user to Portuguese. Okay, there is lots of languages supported, as you can see. P is Portuguese in Portugal. Okay, save. Now let's go back to this one and let's see what the language says. And it says Catachau. So seems to be working just fine. So have fun in translating your .confs.